Welcome to the Blazor DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to export Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component as a stream to a PDF document. First, let me open an existing Blazor web app. I've already added the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component with the data source property bound to the orders list. I've also configured the toolbar with an option to export the data grid to a PDF file. If you want to learn how to add a Blazor data grid component to a Blazor web app, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. For more information on exporting the data grid to a PDF document, refer to the video link provided in the description below. Now, let me run the example application. As you can see, the Blazor DataGrid component has rendered the orders data source. Also notice that the PDF export button is visible in the toolbar. When I click the PDF export button, the PDF document is downloaded in the browser. Upon opening it, you can see that the DataGrid is successfully exported to the PDF document. Now I will show you how to export this Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid as a memory stream. A memory stream temporarily stores PDF data, allowing you to manipulate or download the file directly without saving it to disk. Let's proceed to see the steps to complete this process. To do this, first I need to incorporate the JavaScript method and make a few adjustments to our Blazor component. For that, first navigate to the AppRaiser component. Then I define the script tag within the body section. Within the tag, add a JavaScript function to save a file from a base64 string. This function creates a downloadable link for the file and programmatically clicks it to trigger the download. Inside the function, create an anchor element. After that, I set the download attribute with the desired file name. Then set the hreference attribute to a data URL containing the base64 encoded content. Now I append the anchor element to the document body. Let me invoke the click method to trigger the anchor element. And finally remove the anchor element from the document body. Next, I will update the Blazor component to use this JavaScript function. So return to the home Razor component. I inject the IJS runtime service into our Blazor component. IJS runtime is an interface provided by Blazor that allows you to call JavaScript functions from within your Blazor component. First, within the toolbar click handler method, remove the existing code. Create an instance of the memory stream and use it to call the export to PDF async method using the default grid reference, exporting the grid data as a PDF document. Ensure that as memory stream argument is set to true. This specifies that the export should be performed in memory, returning a memory stream object containing the PDF data. Next, I need to visualize the memory stream as a base64 encoded string. To do this, declare a string variable named base64Stream and assign it by converting the memory stream to a byte array and then encoding it as a base64 string. This step is useful for transferring or displaying binary data in a text format. Then print the base64 stream to the console. This helps visualize the content of the memory stream and verify that the data is correctly encoded. After that, call the saveAsFile JavaScript function to trigger a file download. This function takes two parameters. The first is the file name for the PDF. The second is the base64 encoded PDF data from the memory stream. Let me run the example application. When I click the PDF export button and navigate to the Visual Studio output window, you'll see the memory stream as a base64 encoded string. It allows you to transfer of binary files within XML or JSON payloads. which is useful for tasks like sending email attachments or storing data in a database. Additionally, notice that the PDF is downloaded with the provided name, confirming that the grid data has been successfully exported as a PDF document. Next, I will show you how to convert a memory stream to a file stream for PDF export. This conversion saves the data from memory to a physical file, making it easier to export PDF and preserve the data for later use or sharing. Inside the toolbar clickHandler method, I remove the existing invokeAsync method. Then I create a new memory stream from the existing one, like stream document, ensuring a fresh copy of the data for writing to a file as the memory stream is consumed during the process. Next, I'll specify the exact location where the PDF file will be saved, making sure the path is valid and accessible. I'll use the create method to generate a file stream that allows writing to the specified file path. After that, I'll call the copy method to transfer the contents of the memory stream to the file stream, effectively saving the PDF. Before running this example, I'll set up a notification message to confirm that the file has been successfully downloaded when the PDF export button is clicked. To do this, I'll first declare a private Boolean variable named showNotification and initialize it to false. This variable controls the visibility of the notification message. I'll then create a division element with a message and add inline styles to set the CSS display property based on the value of showNotification. If showNotification is true, the display property is set to block. If false, it's set to none. Within the toolbar clickHandler method, I'll set showNotification to true, indicating that the success message should be displayed, and call the stateIsChanged method to notify the framework that the state has changed and the component needs to be re-rendered. I'll then hide the notification after 3 seconds. Finally, I apply CSS styles, such as color and text alignment, to the provided message. When I click the PDF export button, the message is displayed. I can check the specified location and see that the PDF document is saved with the provided name. Upon opening the PDF document, it confirms that the grid data has been successfully exported. Next, I'll demonstrate how to merge two PDF memory streams. It can consolidate data from multiple sources into a single document, simplifying file management and distribution. This process is useful for combining reports, aggregating documents, or creating comprehensive records from separate PDF files. Before proceeding, I'll remove the existing code for converting memory streams to file streams to ensure a clear understanding of the purpose. Inside the toolbar clickHandler method, I'll create a memory stream called MergeStream to hold the final merge PDF. Next, I'll create the PDF document to display the final merge document. So I import the Syncfusion PDF namespace. Then I'll create a PDF document object called final document to display the final merge PDF. Next, I'll use the export to PDF async method using the default grid to obtain two separate PDF documents as memory stream objects. The first PDF is stored in stream document 1. For the second PDF, I'll apply custom export properties to style the grid. To do this, I'll create a PDF export properties object and configure its theme with custom styles for headers and records. The second PDF is then stored in stream document 2. I'll merge these two PDF documents into the final document using the merge method of the PDF document. I'll save the merge PDF document to the merge stream. Finally, I use JavaScript to notify the user to download the file. When I click the PDF export button, the PDF document is downloaded with the name Memory Stream Merge. Opening the PDF document, you'll see that the grid data from both documents has been successfully merged into a single PDF. Now let me summarize. In this video, I showed you how to export a PDF document in the Blazor DataGrid component. I also demonstrated how to export grid data as a memory stream, convert a memory stream to a file stream, and merge two PDF memory streams. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from that GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.